Whoa, it's hot.
Yay. That looks very melted.
Oh my gosh.
You're doing such a great job.
Thank
I'm so
you.
Impressed right now.
I'm impressed myself.
What are you not good at?
Nothing.
Happy Thanksgiving, WWE Universe. Welcome to another episode of Talking Snack with the boss.
That's right.
Sasha Banks.
And I'm such a good cooker.
No! we are making a chocolate mousse pie for Thanksgiving.
Amazing.
Thanksgiving, what do you do every year now?
I've honestly never really been home for Thanksgiving since I got signed with WWE. Usually I go to Tara from the PC. She's our medical trainer.
Yeah.
She always gets like everyone with NXT together, and we have like this big cookout at her house. And I never really celebrated holidays growing up. So it really, really taught me what Thanksgiving really meant. It's just like being around family and love. So
I love really that cool. NXT family, because there are so many people, especially the international superstars that come
everywhere.
In from everywhere. Like they don't celebrate Thanksgiving.
They just can't go home.
Yeah, they can't go home.
So it's just like Tara's so great at that. She just brings everyone together, and we all bring something, and it's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Basically, what we do for this is start off with a cup and a half of chocolate chips.
That looks really good.
Look great. And a tablespoon of coconut oil. Put it in there. You're gonna pop this in the microwave.
Okay.
20-second intervals, so it doesn't like overheat or get too bubbly.
Make sure I know how to use the microwave.
Yeah.
Let's see. There we go. And then a boom. Yeah, I'm a pro. Look at
so
me.
So good.
Just kidding. So that doesn't look melted at all.
Yeah,
but,
mix it a little bit.
Okay.
Okay, maybe more than 20 seconds.
See, this is why I don't like cooking. I feel like it takes so long.
I know.
And then you have to clean after, like.
Yeah, the boss never has to clean for herself,
no.
Right?
Well, honestly, my husband does all the cooking, I do all the cleaning.
Aww.
But we have to be like a team, you know?
It's a symbiotic relationship.
And he's a great cooker. Like, he loves to cook. All right. Okay, this bowl is definitely getting hotter.
Yeah.
I'm not playing this time.
Melty.
We are getting there, Kathy.
Yeah, we are. The first interview I ever did with you, it was a phone interview, and you were on your way to your grandma's house in Iowa. Your goal at that point was to main event a takeover.
Chills. Yeah, that's so crazy. That's insane. Because I remember that so clearly, too. I remember just being back there, and I'm like, wow, I've really just come so far from that point to being in NXT. And then a week later, I got the call to be called up. And I was like, holy moly. And then like a couple weeks after that, it was NXT Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
Me thinking that was gonna be my last match in NXT, I was like, okay, I have to just leave my heart out there and let them know exactly what I want NXT to mean and what I wanna show the world what NXT means to me.
Yeah.
And you know, we were called the co-main event. There's really no such thing as a co-main event or a second main event. There's only the main event.
That was the main event for me.
And for me, it's just like, kind of like a screw you. I'm gonna show you why I deserve to be the main event. Me and Bailey went out there, we put our heart and soul and everything out there. And because of the match, we got to main event the next takeover. From that point there, it's just like, just kept going more and more from like Hell in a Cell to main eventing a Raw and winning the Raw Women's Championship to just Royal Rumble, Elimination Chamber, seeing the girls on SmackDown do Money in the Bank. It's just like, what? That was like, what, 4 years ago?
Yeah.
3 years ago?
Okay, so next up, you're gonna pour that into the bowl.
Okay.
It is our heavy whipping cream, and then a little bit of vanilla extract.
Okay. Oh, baby.
Well, that's very unimpressive. I thought that was great. Come on.
Oh my gosh, it looks so good. Stop. I'm on a diet. As I break the glass in this bowl, nice.
Well, that's you're always
good,
breaking
right?
glass ceilings.
That's so true.
Breaking glass ceilings, breaking glass bowls.
Can I try this now?
Yes. Technically, we're supposed to put it in the pie first, but.
Oh. I feel like Wendy Williams.
Oh,
like,
you didn't get the bottom. Look at. Okay.
I'm still learning.
I take that back. And then so basically what you do is you take this and you put it in the fridge and you let it set for at least 4 hours, but you can do it overnight if you want to make it in advance. And
see, that cooking takes way too long. Oh my gosh.
So you have accomplished so much within WWE. Are there other things on your bucket list career-wise that you're like, okay, I really, really, really want to do that?
You know, I've been thinking about that a lot lately. I feel like, I don't feel like I'm old. 26 is not old. I have to keep telling myself that. But I have done a lot already. Mm-hmm. Of course, the biggest goal for me is to main event.
26 is not old at all.
WrestleMania, I have to accomplish like that. Like, to me, that's such a far-fetched thing that I never, ever thought would happen. But just to see the growth of what we've done in within 3 years, I know that's possible. And I know that we can make it happen as a group together in such a beautiful division right now where mm-hmm. legit every woman wants to make this place better. We want to be like the guys. We want to keep on having great storylines and
be
more matches. We want to. Like, I want to be better than the guys every time I go out there. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, outside of WWE, I don't have any other dreams. Like, WWE is it for me, so.
Do you have any memories of Iowa, like being that young?
I do. I moved there when I was 9. I stayed with my aunt on a farm in legit the middle of nowhere. And I was the only mixed kid in that whole town. And it was really hard for me. People were so mean to me. Like, they were so racist. And but it also toughened my skin. Like, it made me braver. They made fun of my hair, my color. They made fun of my brother because he has disabilities. Yeah. And it just made me a tougher person. So in a way, I appreciate that. And it's also when I found wrestling.
I know that your mom was working a lot and mm-hmm. trying to, you know, figure everything out for your family. So was that something that you had to deal with on your own?
It is, yeah. And, you know, you just kind of learn on your own and understand what's acceptable and what's not. And you kind of just learn what's right and what's wrong on your own. And I knew that because of what they said was wrong, but I wasn't going to let it affect me mm-hmm. and make me cry or make me lose sleep over it. Because legit, like, they can say names, they can say words, but I would never say it back.
Yeah. Any young kids that are going through something similar where they're being bullied in school or being made fun of, like, what would be your advice to them?
Never be afraid to talk about it. I think that's the bravest thing. I feel like people to this day don't want to get help for things that they need, and it's okay to ask for help. I think that's so important. Nobody knows anybody's story. So I think recently I just learned, like, you know, I can't take anything personal because they don't know my story and I don't know what they're going through. Mm-hmm. So. Whether it's what's name calling and people just being bullies, it's just like, okay, maybe they're dealing with something at home, but I'm gonna be the bigger person, I'm gonna be brave. And if it's really bothering me, I know that I can talk to somebody about it to know that I'm okay and that I'm doing the right thing. And you know, you just gotta keep on going on with your life because there's always gonna be bullies, but as long as you're the better person and you're the star, that's all that matters.
And you're the star now.
I am the star now.
In the spirit of Thanksgiving, I want to know what you are thankful for in your life.
Number one, I am thankful for Bailey. She's my mom.
Aww.
I love her so much. I'm thankful for my family, my husband. I'm thankful that you know, I'm given the opportunity to have this platform to help you know, show that women's wrestling is so important. And, you know, we just got done with our first ever all-women's pay-per-view, Evolution. I'm happy that that was successful. And I hope that there's many, many more. And I hope that we just keep on going more and more and more. And that's what I'm thankful for. I'm just thankful for wrestling. I love wrestling. I love WWE.
I love that.
I love my life.
Are you also thankful for chocolate pies?
I am thankful for chocolate pies.
Because I think the chocolate pie is ready.
Ooh. Let me go get it.
It looks delicious.
It looks amazing. I'm so excited.
Should we dig right in?
Let's do it.
We don't
need a knife. Yeah.
Try it.
Why do you do this to me, WWE? I love it when food is so good you can cry.
You cry about everything. Mom.
I do cry about everything. I'm an emotional person.
We made this.
We made this.
You made something.
I made something.
You cooked. For any WWE Universe members that want to make this at home, the recipe. It's so easy to make. It's so delicious. Mm-hmm. You should definitely make it for Thanksgiving, for all of your friends, or for yourself.
Just yourself. Screw your friends.
Sasha, thank you so much for doing this today.
Thanks for having me.
This is great.
I'm so happy. This makes me, I'm really thankful that I learned how to do this. I'm so nice. Oh, so good.
And we are thankful for all of you guys.
Thank you.
Talking Snack is presented by Hefty. Strong bags at a low price.